Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Let's go through that door as promised and see what's through here. It seems we're getting closer to that central crane with some bulblins guarding a switch. Not very well, I have to say, because they are not strong enemies. They just aren't guarding it well by the sheer nature of them being weaklings. And some fire keys. Good thing I have my Hylian shield. Otherwise that would cause me some issues, because they would burn my shield to charcoal. And I would like to finish. There we go. What about the other one? Finish! Ah, you got up a little too quick. That's fine. And activate! Yeah, if you didn't understand what that surface was on the crane by now, now you do. It's another magnetic plate, magnetic platform for your boots, and this lets you traverse this central area. You don't have to stand on the switch or have anything on it to move on. I don't think there's anything else here, so let's just get ourselves up here. Whee! I think going to the left will take you back to the start, and I do not want to do that, so I'm going to go to the right. Actually, that was to the left. By the way, the camera swung around, but you get what I mean. You're supposed to go over here. Switch. Switches are always good. And this is going to transport me up there. Whee! This is so awesome. No, I don't like you, Keese. I was just flailing around with the sword, and absolutely nothing was happening. And yet, somehow I didn't take any damage whatsoever. I'm just pro like that. anything else of interest? No, I don't think so. Well, fine, be that way. Let's go through here. And... hey, are you Tektites? I think you're Tektites. You're definitely a lot more grotesque than your usual cutesy Tektite. And again, a lot of the enemies in Twilight Princess have a more darker, sinister, grotesque form than they did before in other Zelda games. I know I'm supposed to go underwater, but where am I supposed to go underwater? I do not know. Definitely here, that's for sure. It's a key! Woo! Something I definitely need. It's a lot slower walking underwater than not, and you also have that air gauge, so you can't stay underwater for too long. Oh, right, I'm supposed to go into that area there. But is there any other treasure chests around this area? I don't think so. Let's just flop through here, and can I push? Yeah, I can push. And I can also swim. That sounds like a good idea before I drown. Okay, I don't know what those crates are doing floating there. They're kind of just detail, I suppose. Unless you... can you hit those crates? I'm not sure. I'm going to try a jump attack. Yes, you can. I never tried that before. And a yellow rupee. It didn't tell me what a yellow rupee is. Interesting. I think it was because I was in the water when I grabbed it. And what does that do? Creates one of those, okay. Let's go in. Whee! And I think I can pop off here. Or not. I got a little bit too hasty there. And in turn, I wasted more time than I needed to. Don't you just hate when you do that? When you get a little too hasty trying to get across something quickly and that happens. Oh, I should also give you a closer look at the surface. I really like how this looks. It looks like abstract-y crystalliness. It's so well detailed as well. It looks like something that a fractal generator or something like that in a Photoshop or GIMP-like program could generate. Oh, I'm supposed to jump into that one from up here. Got it! Or flop down from the ledge with the iron boots.
I'll probably just flop down. It seems a little safer. I could just drop down into it, right? Yeah. Some of these, I think, turn themselves off and on, like, in a sequence, so that you have to time yourself with them, but not these just yet. And boop! And there is a treasure chest. And there's also a crystal switch. Wait, what? Oh, I was gonna say. The first hit didn't do anything, it just switched, and then... Or it didn't seem to. Wait. That switch. Ah, I see. I gotta get to that door quick enough. Can I activate it with this? No. This could be a problem. Unless I really go. Oh, never mind. That wasn't a problem at all. Die! No, Beamos! I hate Beamos! I'm still on fire. In this game, I need another item to be able to do something about them. So I can't really do anything to them right now, and I don't know what that did. Yeah, what did that switch do? I have absolutely no idea. I assume it's something that I have to run. So it's probably something through the center. Go. Is this something? I'm puzzled. Well, I can't hit that switch with any of my items right now from a distance, so I'm just gonna have to scout out up here first and see what that switch might unlock and which way do I want to go. Oh, no, I'm sideways. I forgot that. How weird this looks. That's back down. Okay, to that ledge I go, I think. Just seems familiar to me. Maybe because that has a compass? I don't know. I hope it's the compass. I pressed A in front of the chest, and I rolled instead. It's a piece of heart! Yeah! That's a delightful prize. But it doesn't really help me get through here. Nor does it recover my health, because I didn't take any damage. Not meaning I was at full health, but you know what I mean. And boop. Alright. Bet you have to cut this. Yep. That key opens. I mean, the key that I got and the other one goes over there, apparently. Into that door. So it's a good thing I got the key. And still, what the heck does that switch do? This one. You. I'm going to hit you, and... Oh, it's for that! Oh, I'm an idiot! Why didn't I think of that before? That's to get out of the room, not for anything in this room in particular to progress. Oh, the sharpshooting room. This reminds me of some sort of, like, Western shootout or something like that. Because you got those archery bulblins up there with fire arrows shooting down at you. They have a limited range, so you don't have to worry about them too much, and you've got a lot of guards along the way. Like, you can use these just to hide behind between their shots. I could probably hit them with the slingshots, but I'm not sure if that'll do anything more than stun them. And I don't think I can even hit them from this distance, because the slingshot bullets... Yeah, you see that they like have a limited... range in... Well, maybe I can. Oh, that worked! And it seems to kill them as well, because they fall into the water! Very nice! This pleases PkGam greatly. I think there's something down in the water for me, though. So I'm going to take a swim and see if there is something. I thought so. I can attack on the water with my sword, right? Yeah, I thought so. Gimme! I want mucho prizo. Purple rupee! That's nice since I spent a ton of cash on that shield. I think that's the only thing that was underwater, if memory serves me. I will have to come through this room again, hopefully after I get the compass, so yeah. Anyway, over here is something that... I don't think I have to come through here just yet. So I'm going to just flop myself up here. Wait, actually, yes, I should go and do the lore route first. I'm confusing myself. Always clear out one section at a time. It just makes things a little bit easier to keep track of in the long run. Oh, wait. This is taking me back to... No, this is the upper route. So I did explore everything. Yay! there's a crate I can push, apparently. I think you can push this... No, you can't push that crate. I need a key for that door, but I will take a walk up there anyway. Okie dokie. I'll just hop across. Beamos. I do not appreciate your presence here. I do, however, appreciate the presence of this treasure chest with a small key. Okay, I'm just gonna go to the other door. I can't do anything about the Beamos. There's multiple pathways, as you can see, that I can take through this room, so... Let's just do one thing at a time, then clear out things once I get the ye olde compass, because I'll know what I have to have left to clear out. Ah, this. You're gonna have to use the iron boots once you get to the center. Or at least right here. You're best off using your iron boots on the side that has three flippy panels. Because then you can just do like this for safety. And obviously you can't move too far forward, otherwise you're just gonna flop right off the platform. So yeah, keep that in mind. What's beyond this door? I don't know. And I'll probably jump in the water when I get back out here later. Ooh! Another key! Well, another key fragment. What's up?
Oh, the young human. I am pleased to see you made it this far, brother. I am one of the four elders of the Goron tribe. I am called Gor Ebzio. Ebizo. I am mispronouncing my own name. You ever heard of the plight of our patriarch? Otherwise, you would not have come to see me. Here, take this, brother.
So, we have another key shard. 2 out of 3. Hey, how do you know I already had the other shard? Has word of mouth spread that far already? Oh, and it's interesting to note that if you look at the key shards, they have that magnetic material on the inside of them, so when they attach to each other, they are, can I actually show that in the inventory screen? I don't think so. What about the map screen? Haha, see that bluish green on the inside of the key? Yeah, that's to indicate that they can attach to each other via the magnetic power. Yellow rupee! Thank you for telling me what it is. Anything in here? Maybe? There's another ladder I'm probably gonna have trouble with. Yes, I am. It's like you... If you don't get onto the ladder slowly and directly, it sort of bounces you off. It's kind of weird. Wait a second, before I move and progress, I would like to go back to this room and plop into the water to see if there's anything that I missed down there. Something tells me this is just going to be a waste of time. Well, there's you. I can't attack you in my current helpless state. Nor do I really feel like it. Treasure chest? I need you, treasure chest. Where are you? If there is any. I don't know if there is any. I'm just being random as usual. Can I climb up on this dead end? Yes, I can. That's kind of weird. Whoa! It's a flipping platform just kind of move me to the side in midair. Never happened to me before. Okie dokie. It looks like there really isn't anything over here. This probably leads me back to the door that I use the flippy platform to get across. Yeah, so I'm going to have to track back over to the other room as quickly as I can. Boop! I didn't want to waste time there. Roll, roll, roll! Yeah! Didn't even have to wait that time. And I noticed that this part is getting close to the 16-minute mark, so I think I'm going to finish off that other room on the upper level and then end off the part. Come on, Link! Let's hurry! Upskirt shop. And boop. Wait, did I look all the way over to the left over here? I don't. Yeah, there isn't anything over here. I'm just worried that I missed the compass somewhere. Anyway, let's move on and walk on walls. I cannot imitate that voice, but this really is pretty awesome. I hope there's no enemies coming along the way. No, I'm safe. Unless a fire piece decides to ruin my day. Wait, did I see something along? Yeah, there is a treasure chest. I could actually plop off over here, couldn't I? Is that, that's just going to take me, yeah, right above that door, so I'm just going to do that. And open says me. My wallet's almost full, actually, once again. And I think that's all I can do in this room at the moment. So, I'm going to end off the part here before I enter this door. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next parts.